The new training camp.
Yep. Camp experience. They're happy.
They love it.
All 10, you know, are here. They like it.
They're staying at the camp house?
There's some that are very talented. This one right here is pretty talented.
He's from Dallas?
You're from Dallas?
No. Dickinson, Texas.
What?
Dickinson, Texas?
Dickinson.
It's like 30 minutes south of Houston.
Oh, so I will call you from Houston. What's your name?
Angel.
Angel what?
Angel Avila.
How'd you end up in the gym?
It's true. I flew out, you know, got invited. I went ahead, you know. But everybody's cool.
Rock. Are you amateur?
Yes, sir.
How many fights?
Six.
Only so you just starting?
No, I've been boxing since I was 15.
So why? How old are you now?
How old are you? 21.
One fight a year.
One fight per year.
Yeah,
that's
I
like right now.
Three this past year. Three wins right now. So I'm on a 3-win streak.
But Robert says you're pretty good.
I'm getting there. Just a lot of practice, a lot of training.
How do you like this experience?
It's amazing. You know, it's something I probably won't ever forget. You know, I could tell everybody.
They're all good kids.
I went to Robert's gym and this and that. You know, they're all.
That's
good
true.
Kids,
you know? They're all good kids, man. I'm telling you, they're all. It's crazy because I thought. You know, you don't know who's gonna show up.
Correct.
Yeah, when we did this, and we're gonna do it more often. But you know, I thought we could get just a hardcore fan that
yeah,
might never
yeah, yeah.
been fought before.
Correct.
Just
a super fan. Yeah.
Exactly. Or maybe somebody that might be getting ready for a professional fight. But nah, they're all. There's only one professional fighter, but he's from Mexico.
Yeah, 4-0, tall kid.
He's 1-0. He has one fight at the pros, too.
If I ever get in a street fight, I'm calling you on speed dial. Looks like you have a lot of experience.
Yeah.
I can
see,
tell.
So, they're all fighters. They're all amateurs and two pros, but they're all fighters. So they're all here to learn, to experience what a training camp is.
What professionals,
that's
what
awesome,
the
man.
Best of the best.
Yeah,
what's the one thing you love the most?
I say the food's pretty good.
You agree?
The food's good.
The food?
Yeah,
the food's
good.
Well, how about, forget the food, what about the boxing
definitely
stuff? What have you
training.
Learned?
Definitely
like what?
Training.
What's the one thing you learned?
Definitely the mitts.
You never did mitts like that?
Very specific, basic, oriented, you know, 1, 2, 3.
The punches that you throw in a fight. See, that's our system, you know.
Yes.
There's a lot of other trainers that do all this
flashy stuff. Yep.
But you don't do that in a fight. So we do what you're going to do in a fight. It's jab, the 1-2.
Mayweather never did those mitts in a fight.
Counter.
It's a lot
Mayweather,
more technical. Yeah.
But Mayweather is the only one that could, you know, do all that and throw very few punches in a fight.
A sniper. And be accurate.
Exactly.
You know, but he didn't throw 1,000 combos.
Mayweather did it doesn't mean everybody else can do it, and everybody else is doing it, thinking that they could do it. You know what I mean? So it's just everybody's different. You know, some fighters you have to teach them how to block and counter. Some you have head movement, you know, slip punches and stuff like that. But it's you know, but when you see a Mayweather, who everybody
copies, of course, he
wants to be like, and that's when they start doing. Coaches start doing it to every fighter. They're not supposed to.
What about this? Chavez Sr. never did mitts except for a little period.
Until he started training with
Emmanuel Stewart. You know that?
Yeah.
Chavez Sr. never did mitts.
Never did mitts. Only sparred
and heavy bag. That's
yeah.
it?
Never did. Mm-hmm. He doesn't know how to hit the speed bag.
And he's still in shape.
Yeah. He said the only thing he did was heavy bag and sparring. A lot of sparring.
I interviewed someone.
Sparring is very important. Sparring is the most important thing in boxing. Man. Learn a lot from sparring. Obviously, you're not going to be taking beatings every sparring session. You know, you got to, obviously, the trainer has to protect that too.
Kind of like spectate.
But that's the best.
Jeff, yeah. I talked to Jeff Fennec this week from Australia.
Uh-huh.
He was champ at 118, 122, 126. He never did speed back ever.
Yeah.
And he still coaches guys. They don't do speed back.
Yeah. That's good. You know, shoulder keeps your ties on your shoulder.
It looks cool. So
it's eye coordination. You know, it does. You know, it's not. But you could box. You could live. Could be a boxing career without speed bag.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.